Hello everybody, welcome back. This is the Kirin Rise Wing Chun University. I'm Ed Cruz. Like I said, I will be doing videos for quite a bit for the next 30 days on a regular basis, and I'm here to answer some of the questions. Yesterday I posted my first announcement about being able to pre-order book 2 of Kirin Rise series. Once again, the information will be listed below. And like I said, one of the big benefits of getting the $30 package I'm offering, besides all the pre-order books, comics that I'm supplying with that, is 1 month free access into the Kirin Rise Wing Chun University. I actually got several emails today regarding questions. Well, I've seen your Windy City Wing Chun Gung Fu Beginner series. A lot of people said it's one of the most viewed series out there. And they're like, what's the difference between that and the Kirin Rise Wing Chun University? Right? Well, the Windy City Wing Chun Beginner series is simply that. It's basic concepts, and I'm just exposing people to the art of Wing Chun. The Kirin Rise Wing Chun University is a full curriculum from beginner, intermediate, and advanced. Right now we have the full curriculum for beginners set up, and I'm adding on more and more. And like I said, within a year's time, just a year, I've had over 200 videos. And I think that's probably more than the Windy City that I've had for over 6, 7, 8 years from now. Okay, so like I said, click the link below, find the Kickstarter, join. Okay. Anyway, let's talk a little bit about Wing Chun. Okay, and I'm going to give you a little preview of some of the things that we discussed. A lot of misconceptions in Wing Chun, and that's perfectly fine. Not everyone can see it for what it is. So there's always a debate: is Wing Chun defensive, offensive, and so forth? And there's a yes and no to each of that answer. So think about it this way: you have development and application. What I develop is what? A skill. I'm developing a skill to fight, right? I'm developing the skill to fight. I'm not applying the same development into application. So what are examples that I've said before in the past when you see that? Development is your Ichikimi Ma stance. So how many times have we seen a video of someone actually fighting an Ichikimi Ma stance? That is, leads to trouble because you can't do, what are you developing to do in a real fight? Okay, two different things. If you're standing like this in the stance in a real fight situation and you're trying to apply it in a real fight situation, almost 100% of the time, you're gonna lose. Because people can misconstrue, misunderstand what you're trying to develop. When I work on the stance, right, the main thing I'm working on the stance is to control one center of gravity. Okay, I'm trying to be able to control my center of gravity so I don't lean forward, I don't lean back, I have stable support of my body. But if I try to do the same thing, right, in an actual fight situation, you're too rigid. In a real fight situation, you're just naturally standing. And by that time, you know how to move because you're learning how to control, you've learned how to control your center of gravity. But if you're standing like this robotically in a fight, you'll never make it work. Okay? So, and then another thing you see, Chisa is our main exercise. Okay? Now, the interaction between the two is often confused again, because you'll see someone in the fight and all of a sudden they're thinking they can apply pock and lock just like you're doing in a drill at school. Once again, that doesn't work. That doesn't work. Because what is the purpose of the chi sao, right? Okay? People think the chi sao is just sensitivity. Yes, it's sensitivity in the basic level. Alright, but I'm learning the skill of using my two hands equally and not the same way. When you see, a lot of times you see Wing Chun, we're working on the structure, but then in application you get rid of the structure. That's not the case, right? That's not the case. So too often than not, people get confused. What is development? What is application? Okay. So the end question then that a lot of people don't understand is why do we practice so much defense, right? Why is the defense always happening? Because if you watch professional fighters, any kind of fighters, right? The reason the defense is there is to give you confidence. We work on blocking. So I have the balls to actually step in into a fight. But how often do you see a fight that all of a sudden someone's like this? They train all the time, but they're afraid to move in. Wing Chun, once the decision is made, I'm going in, I'm going in. Why can I go in confidently? It's because of my defense. All right? Now, a lot of people get confused with this. What am I doing? Am I waiting for that individual to punch at me? No. I want that individual to react to me, not the other way around. So I can go in because I know I have defense. If I didn't know how to defend, I stay back. All right? But when I actually engage, I'm throwing an attack. Okay? My attack is my defense. The willingness to be able to block is my ability to go in. So once again, this is the kind of stuff that we cover. We cover it in great detail at the Kirin Rise Wing Chun University. If you want to join, follow the link below.